Okay, so normally I work out with my phone, which is actually what's recording this video. My heart rate watch, which I'm getting ready to set up. And like I said, so normally I'm listening to music, but in order to do that, I have to use my phone. I ordered this November 30th, and today is December the 17th. I really haven't worked out in 3 weeks. And 3 weeks doesn't sound like a long time, but trust me, 3 weeks is enough time for you to lose whatever you have established as a good cardio thing. And I'm just gonna start this out on an easy program. As soon as I figure out how to, let's see, program. 21 minute interval, calorie burn, fat burn, stairs, manual, 7 minute, 14, 21 calorie. So normally I would do on my elliptical, I would do a 45-minute workout that was a 21-minute interval. So I'm going to do the 21-minute interval. And I'm not sure. My heart rate got to 139. The step seems too short. Got to 158 that time. Oh, I hate this short step. About 160. Let's see what this says I'm at. This says about 129. My heart rate says, or my watch says 150. Compared to my watch, so it's got 21 minutes, average calorie burn rate 60, average heart rate 119, average RPM 37, 21 minutes, 12 out of 12, 127 total calories. Now my Polar watch, let me get into some better lighting. This is the Polar Advantage V. Before it, I had the Polar V800. Before it, I had the Polar. So the Polar watches I've owned is the current one, the Vantage V. Before it, I had the V800. Before that, I had the FT60. And before that, I had the FT4. So my watch is showing I did 238 calories, 23 minutes, and my heart is still slowing down. So anytime I work out, I wait until my heart rate goes to normal before I stop the workout, because when you have elevated heart rates, when you're burning the most calories. So if you're doing workouts to lose weight, you really need a way to track calorie burn until your heart actually goes back to normal. So whatever your normal, I usually wait until it gets out of zone one, which for me is about 80 something. So there's that one. The next time I do a workout on the M8, I'll actually record it from a first person's perspective.